He's very much an actor's director. He has a really intelligent, intrinsic understanding of character. He's a total visionary, and so I'm so lucky that I've been given an opportunity to work with him and play a character as nuanced and incredible as Anora is. We met, we had a coffee, and also Samantha Kwan, who's his partner and producer as well, was there. And I think we all just really connected and got along in a creative way, and so it just felt really perfect and smooth.
The first idea I had, what would happen if suddenly this Annie's, whose significant other just fled and left her, abandoned her, and suddenly she has to hold her own against these henchmen. Like, what would happen in that situation? It was all built around that. Karan Karagulian, we go way back. He's been in every one of my films. And we were discussing this idea for close to 20 years. I mean, we just had to figure out what the story was. So it was really the setting first. And then eventually over the years, I think because of my research that I had done into sex work and my connection to sex workers, we finally came up with this sort of high concept idea of like what would happen if a young sex worker married the son of a Russian oligarch. And when we came up with that exact idea, then things started to move. It kind of wrote itself from that point. I had beginning, middle, and end. It was at that point that we met Mikey. And Mikey was really, casting her before I wrote the screenplay was so important because I was able to write this screenplay with her in mind. It made it real in my mind.
I read the script a handful of months after meeting Sean, and we were in communication while he was writing it as well, but when I read it, I was just totally blown away. It was more interesting and complicated and just better than I ever would have imagined. And also as an actor, there were so many things that I got to do and like sink my teeth into. So I was really excited about hopefully creating a really complex, nuanced character to do justice to his film. So I did a lot of mental preparation, lots of studying about sex work and physical preparation as well. I worked with a dance coach for many months to realistically portray a dancer. I learned Russian, so I did quite a bit for this film, more than I've ever done for a role previously. I loved it, especially making a film like his that I think is so fluid in lots of different ways, that at times improvisation was really necessary. Mm. And so I loved it, but I think I also just knew my character so well at the time of shooting that I was able to easily add things. All of the other actors I worked with were very intuitive, intelligent actors, and so we were able to seamlessly improvise as needed.
Some of my favorite lines come from my actors who were just amazing. And then, of course, yes, there were full sequences in which we did rely 100% on improv because I was shooting in a docu-style way. And Mikey was so comfortable and confident, I think, from her research that she did. She understood Annie so well that I could let her improvise for 10 minutes and she would be in character and giving me gold and giving me actual exposition. The beginning of the film, especially, before she even meets Yvonne at the club, I was shooting that whole opening sequence like I was always thinking Robert Altman in my mind. I wanted to create this environment. So we had all of our actors and our dancers spread throughout the club and everybody was doing their own thing. They were allowed to talk. They were, you know, often background has to keep silent and lip their dialogue. No. I wanted this to be, you know, a live club. We even had our producer in the DJ booth blasting music. I wanted it to feel like a real club. And then what we did was that we had Mikey with a wireless mic. I shot from the other side of the club with a telephoto lens, and we just watched her and observed her. She had an earpiece, and I would tell her, okay, go over to that man over near the bar and try to pick him up. And she would go over and she would have a conversation with him. And I say, okay, we got some good stuff. Move on to the next guy. And she would move on to the next guy. And we shot 30 minutes of this. And now we had to whittle it down to only 4 minutes in the film. I have 30 minutes of gold of watching of Mikey on her own having to improvise. And it's really incredible footage.
I left more confident as an actor and a performer because Sean really made it clear that my ideas and my opinion was really valued and important to him. And I was asked questions by him about the script and the character that nobody's really asked me before. So I think it gave me more of a confidence. I think all the preparation I did, like I did more than I needed to. There were definitely scenes that were difficult. Learning Russian was really a challenging part of playing the character for me.
She was very much on my mind in terms of just somebody, an actor I might want to work with. And then I saw Scream, and Scream solidified it and said, okay, she's the one. And I turned to my wife and producer, Samantha, and I said, we're going to call her agent the minute we leave the theater. I pitched her this idea, and she returned this wonderful enthusiasm. I mean, I could see that she was going to take this quite seriously. Mm-hmm. This wasn't just another job. She was going to be dedicated. She was going to take on a New York accent. She was going to learn pages and pages of Russian dialogue. She was going to learn the pole. You know, she took pole dancing lessons for months for like literally a 25-second shot, but just so that she could look like she really owned it, and this was Annie's livelihood, and we had to believe it. Mikey just took all those steps, all those incredible steps that, you know, a dedicated actor takes to fully accomplish a performance like that.
She's a lot more energetic than I am. I was exhausted every day after filming because I was exerting so much energy to play her because I wanted her to be very lively and free-spirited. And reading the script, I had an idea of how I wanted to feel and how I wanted to play her. But I think it's really when we started shooting that I realized what was necessary for the character.
It's just about, like, with each film, just approaching this in a way that it's like, we're not gonna judge, we're just gonna show. We're not gonna sanctify any characters because we're not gonna like make them perfect, because why would you do that? You make them human, fully fleshed out, three-dimensional characters with hopes and dreams and flaws. I mean, the flaws are the important part of it, because I think we recognize, we all know we're imperfect. When we see imperfect characters, we recognize ourselves and we can have greater empathy for them. And I think the ultimate goal is to have empathy for these characters.
He was the ultimate collaborator, and we had already created like a friendship by the point of filming, so that we felt really free and comfortable to share everything with each other. I mean, it's strange. I almost feel like we were in some ways, like we were just on a very similar wavelength creatively. There were even times where we would be trying to like rewrite a scene mm-hmm. before shooting it, and we would be like, what's this line? And we would look at each other and say the line exactly at the same time. So it was very strange. I think it was just this sort of kismet relationship that we had, at least I. But yeah, he's a very caring director. He's very thoughtful. He's very much an actor's director. He has a really intelligent, intrinsic understanding of character. So I'm really lucky that I had a director like that.
I will forever look back at Enora and say, you know, this was just, I was working with the perfect cast and crew. It just seemed like everybody was not only so talented, but everybody was on the same page in terms of sensibility, and everybody was on the same page in terms of passion. Like every day, people would bring 110% because they wanted to make the best film possible. And I had every department in my crew giving me ideas, and I could take it or leave it, but they were great ideas and they enhanced what I had on the page. And so did my actors, they enhanced everything. So I really just look back, and I'm gonna always look back fondly on this experience because it was such a wonderful team.
I've never quite had an experience like this before, so it's all very new for me. I really had no idea what to expect, and I still don't. But it's been really wonderful. I feel very welcomed everywhere I go, and I'm so happy that we're able to show our film in so many incredible places.
Tout va bien se passer.